Hi everyone. In this course, we will talk about Spring Boot hot swapping. When you are working with any application, it is hard to restart and run the application for every changes. In this course, we will solve this problem. I'm using IntelliJ IDEA. I will show all the details by using this IDEA. If you use Eclipse, it's almost same, but there is some subtle differences. Let's open the project. Our project is a time leak project. Firstly, I want to show hot swapping on the GUI. Let's open the application properties. If you use TimeLeaf, you need to add some property in here. The property name is Spring Boot .TimeLeaf cache. The value should be false. And let's test it. I want to start the application. Let's open some pages. For example, login page under the template and go to the login. I want to add something here. Okay. Open the browser. In here, as you see, it's remember me, but I change it as test. As you see, it is not working now. You should press Ctrl F9. For the IntelliJ IDEA, you need to do this, but for Eclipse, you don't need to do this. And open here, refresh the page. As you see, the remember me test now. Remove this test stuff and press the Ctrl F9 for IntelliJ IDEA and go to the URL, refresh. Now it's working. Let's try with Java codes. Go to the any controller and I want to change this test. And now login. Delete this task. Delete. This task goes to the trash box. And after restore, we will see any message. I change this message. Let's see what happened for the message. Okay. The message is not changed. Let's go to the here. As you see, we add the tasks. But the message is not changed. Let's press Ctrl F9 and as you see, stores, parsing, building and finished. Test it again. Okay. Delete this task and go to the trash box. Restore the task. The message is not changed. The reason is that we start the application. For this case, for Java code changes, we must start as debug mode. Let's stop it and restart in the debug mode. If you restart as a debug mode, hot swapping working for Java code changes also. Otherwise, it's only working for these GUI changes. For the GUI changes, we add these properties. Okay, let's see. Login. Go to the task. Delete task. Go to the trash box. Restore the task to the test. Now we want to remove this and test it again. Press the Ctrl F9. After pressing, you will see this. Okay, press yes. As you see, application class reloaded. In debug mode, it's reloaded. But for the run mode, it's not reloaded. Okay, just try again. Delete. go to the trash box, and the message is changed. There is another way for the Eclipse also. It's not working for IntelliJ IDEA, but if you change something, it will work for IntelliJ IDEA. You have to add some dependencies. The dependency name is DevTools. Boot DevTools. After adding these dependencies, you expected it works, but for IntelliJ IDEA actually it's not working. You need to press Control F9, or you need to change some settings. Go to the settings in here. If you don't see this menu bar, go to the view and activate your menu buttons toolbar. Yes, go to the view, activate the toolbar, or go to the file and settings, it's same. Go to the settings or Control S, and in here, as you see, automatically show first error. Compile, build project automatically. You have to select this checkbox in your project, maybe it's not selected. Select this checkbox and click apply, click OK, then press the Control Shift A and type the registry here. Check this compiler auto make allow when app is running. Check this checkbox and close it. Restart your IDEA. After this, it should work for the IntelliJ IDEA. If you use this dependency, it may not work. But if you change the first good, go to the compiler and select the build project automatically. Click the OK and Control Shift A. Type the registry. Add this. I don't prefer this. You may prefer this the second way for IntelliJ IDEA, but for Eclipse you don't need to do anything because this compiler plugin will work for you. That's all about hot swapping. See you next video.